Filippula holds into Zetterberg, looks for help, leaves it there to Stewart. Bertuzzi couldn't pick it up. Zetterberg will, back in front. Score!
No goal.
No goal.
Wow.
They say, as Bertuzzi in front either kicks or interferes.
You know what the ruling's going to be here? I don't think there's a penalty to Todd Bertuzzi, but I think they're going to rule that he was in a position where the goaltender couldn't make his move to stop the puck. I don't know if I agree with it, but I believe that's what the ruling is going to be. You be the judge by our first replay. Oh, boy.
Well, also off his skate, too. He was the goal scorer, Bertuzzi.
Yeah, right.
And his right skate.
Well, he directed it into the net with his skate. He did not kick it in. And then by looking at these replays, the goaltender couldn't have gotten to the puck anyway. He didn't even make contact to him. This would look like a bad call if it's what I thought it was.
Now, there's a little motion.
Now, Toronto's looking at this either Tim Peel has made the call for interference and no goal, or he ruled kicking motion no goal. And if that's the case,
hard to kick from backwards.
I know, there is a motion there. We'll keep an eye on his right foot.
He directs
pushes it on the inside, but there's a motion.
Now
that foot comes in.
Yeah,
right there. Boom. He runs into the goalie's pad, but still, he's
now, you know what?
Kicking it towards the net.
If we can have a look, guys, at that one more time, I'd like to hone in on that right skate. And if the rule reads that you can't have a kicking motion to put the puck in the net, you assume that it's a forward kicking motion. Now, watch his right skate. Hold it right there, guys. Watch this right skate here and watch him take it and move it towards the net and direct the puck in. Go ahead.
And you know what?
But, he was moving his foot back. The puck hit the blade. You can direct it in with your skate if you don't kick it in. So we just don't know. If he'd have made the call that he interfered with the goaltender, I don't think there's no review for that.
I'm with you. Now, he's taking this long to feel that there must be.
It had to be the kicking motion. Yeah,
I think you're right.
Which is a better chance for the Red Wings to get a good result on the decision here.
Now it's up to a former Red Wing, Chris King, if he's in the office tonight in Toronto in the Roger Nielsen video room, and Mike Murphy and Colin Campbell and all their great people that work so hard there watching all the games across the NHL. They're reviewing this one now.
Well, once again, you can direct the puck into the net off your skate. That is not illegal. You cannot kick it with a kicking motion. It can go off your skate, but that right foot comes back a little bit, but, you know.
Very subtle.
It is. It hits him there. The foot continues back. I guess you could look at that and say he kicked back.
Shorten that, Murph. Todd Bertuzzi looking at Larry Murphy.
Here we go.
Here's the ruling from Tim Peel. Let's hope we can hear him.
After video review, it has been determined that the puck was not kicked in, therefore we have a good goal.
Good goal. Oh, baby. Two good decisions in a row for Detroit. Wow.
Ty Bertuzzi just said to me that he didn't see the puck when it hit his foot. He was battling to go to the net. He said it was a surprise when it hit his foot. Now,
that's great news.
And that has nothing to do with your foot moving forward or backward. That foot can be going north and south at the same time when you're battling in front of the net. So the Red Wings get a favorable call.
And catch a break on that one.
Have a two-goal lead.
Because the referee on the ice ruled no goal, so video review in Toronto says no, it was good. And now those were the definitive looks. They saw it.